A Mercury Bus Lines turnpiker carrying both colored and white protesters is scheduled to arrive in Breland this afternoon. Dubbed a freedom ride, the tactic is meant to protest segregated conditions on interstate bus travel. Violent confrontation has followed the bus's path, and local police have vowed to deal harshly with any attempt to integrate the bus terminal facility. Earlier,
I had to gunk the pan. New clutch cable's working fine. Now, word to the wise, John Law catch you putting around town, you're gonna lose your license before you get it.
Stop?
No. We have to stop.
Why?
I have to be home soon.
You know what I always wondered? How come you decided to show up at my house that day of the funeral? When we never really knew each other.
My sister says I'm attracted to pain.
What?
I was attracted to you. The month the school went by and you never noticed. What?
I was just wondering what my dad would say if he found out I got a bike.
Go crazy, most likely. That's what my dad does at a drop of a hat. I swear he's gonna have a coronary one of these days.
He doesn't give me a choice. I've got to lie. And once he's made up his mind, it's like, there's no room for discussion, Nathan.
That's probably a good time to talk to him again. You know, he might feel sorry for you since your mom died and everything. Play the sympathy thing. I'm sorry.
I'm not gonna go getting all emotional again.
Greek heroes like Ulysses and all, they used to sit down and cry all the time. It's nothing to be ashamed of.
I believe we can prosecute under Robinson patent for restraint of trade due to price discrimination if we can establish a quantity price differential.
I'd like to move on to the Landis case. Did you review the trial transcript?
I got into it last night. No. Sorry.
Those guys have already been exonerated, Forrest.
Why do I have to start over again each time? We're going after them in a federal court, trying to get a conviction under the statute 18 U.S.C. 241 and 242.
I was under the impression we had a backlog of cases. Why are we doing this?
A week and a half ago, I took my son for an ice cream cone. We ran into a parade on Main Street. There was a cheering crowd. They were celebrating the acquittal of the two men who, in all likelihood, murdered Colonel Landers. My 7-year-old son, all he saw was a parade, of course. He wanted to join it. That's why we're going to prosecute this case.
I guess we have a responsibility, you know, to our young.
That's right.
1944, a sheriff named of Claude Screws got liquored up. Arrested a colored boy, handcuffed him, beat him to death with a blackjack out front of the county courthouse. State didn't see any reason to file a murder charge. But the feds got an all-white jury to convict under your statute 18 U.S.C. 241 and 242.
Right.
That's the good news. The bad news is Screws appealed all the way to the Supreme Court and got the decision reversed on the reasoning that he never willfully intended to deprive that boy of his civil rights. Screws maintained, and the government could not prove otherwise, that his only specific intent was to kill him.
Interesting, Brad, what you do know about this.
That's called the Screws precedent. And that's what you're going up against.
We interrupt this broadcast. The so-called Freedom Bus was sighted crossing the Breland County line some 10 minutes ago. Stones and bottles were thrown as it passed through Anderson without stopping. Sources report a large police contingent at the Breland bus terminal, as well as the presence of many local Negroes in protest.
Lucy and Van Ness, I'm Reverend Henry. This way, please.
Excuse me. Dad? Are you busy?
Yes, I am. I'm busy.
I was wondering, when I get my license, I'd like to buy a bike.
I already have a perfectly good bicycle.
I meant a motorcycle.
Nathan, we've already had this discussion.
Look, I've got some money saved, and it wouldn't cost me as much if I bought a used one and fixed it up.
Money is not the issue. It's a matter of safety. You're 16 years old, you've got a life and a future ahead of you, and a motorcycle is out of the question. Speaking of your driver's license, have you been studying?
I lost the booklet.
Wonderful.
That is no big deal. It only takes 70% to pass. Okay, if I ace it, can I get the bike?
I never told you what happened to Sandy McCracken. He went all through Korea, 18 months in combat without getting a scratch. Got out of the army, bought a motorcycle, and lost his leg in an accident the first week he had it.
He only had his leg for a week?
That may be amusing, Nathan, but it definitely won't win your case.
Come on, Dad. You can get hurt doing anything. Mom got run over by a car. You can get killed by a bus.
If you want to buy a bus, I have no objections.
Swift, Dad.
You from around here, sister?
Born and raised.
Friendly little town. My usual terrain is 19th century romantic poetry.
All right, folks, listen up.
Under the present circumstances, it's probably best if we stay here in Breland for a night or two. As you know, Jay Weber and Sam Hughes have been arrested. Before we can get on another bus, we got to get them released.
I don't believe we'll have any trouble finding volunteers to take you into their homes. Horton Dickerson, why don't you stay at my house? Let's see, Mimi...
McGaffin.
Mimi McGaffin. How about you and Sister Harper hook up? George Curtis, Justin Treadway. Okay, why don't you stay with Mr. and Mrs. Wilmot? Janet Brown?
Do you live here alone?
No, with my father and daughter.
Would you like some tea?
Oh, no, thanks. I can't take caffeine.
Please sit down.
Oh. Reverend Henry isn't exactly enthusiastic about what we're doing, is he?
What do you mean?
I just sense he's from the old school. Patience breeds victory, make nice with Lucifer.
I think you're wrong. Reverend Henry's very committed.
Sorry, I'm compensating. I guess I'm a little nervous.
I'm a little nervous too, to be honest. I hope you don't mind sleeping on the couch.
Are you kidding? Places I've slept in the last week, the couch looks great. What do you do, Lilly, for a living?
I take care of a man's house and his children.
You're a maid?
Yes.
What about you? What school do you go to?
University of Chicago. I'm in graduate school, history. I'm focusing on the history of the American Negro, which is, of course, a history of oppression. Those bastards better not hurt Jay. Jay Weber, one of the guys arrested?
See your boyfriend?
Well, sort of. I mean, we slept together a couple of times. Big deal, right? I don't think true love's all it's cracked up to be. Do you?
Well, let's just say I was raised differently.
Who started the fire?
Papa. This is Mimi McGaffin. Mimi, this is my father, Lewis Coleman.
Good to meet you.
My pleasure, I'm sure.
Mimi's one of the Freedom Riders.
Is that so? I read about you folks in the newspaper. Funny, you don't look like a Russian.
Mimi's going to be staying with us for a few days.
Really?
Is it a problem? Because if it is, I can stay somewhere else.
No, it's not a problem.
I thought this administration had made its position perfectly clear on the matter of civil rights.
Unless it blows us out of the water politically. Why do you think they picked you, Forrest?
You're a man of moderation.
You're telling me that it might not be considered politically expedient to prosecute Southern whites acquitted of killing a Negro?
I'm telling you, just make damn sure you got all your ducks in a row.
I do, all of them. You're gonna have to get up here and pitch this one to the Attorney General.
Is that really necessary?
Yes, it is. I'll set up a meeting.
In for a penny, in for a pound.
By far.
Goodbye, Nick. Good morning, Lilly.
Good morning.
Lilly, could you plan on staying over one night this week?
I have to try to make arrangements. What night would it be?
Well, I'm not sure yet, but I might have to go to Washington on business.
Washington, D.C.?
That's right. Is that going to be a problem for anybody, my being gone overnight?
Could you bring me something?
What'd you have in mind?
A gun.
I'll see what I can do.
How come you're going to Washington, D.C.?
To meet with the Attorney General.
Really? Robert Kennedy?
I'm going to discuss the Landis case with him.
Wow, he's so cute.
Cute? He's 35 years old and he's married and he's got about a dozen kids.
Now listen, y'all. We've been talking about souvenirs and guns, but how about my being away so soon after Mom died? How do y'all feel about that?
You promise you'll only be gone one night?
I promise.
Are you going on an airplane?
Yes, I am.
What if it crashes?
It won't.
But what if it does?
Would you like it better if I took the train? Well, that's what I'll do then.
Good, because trains don't crash. Except last week I read where a plane crashed into one.
What does your father think about you being down here?
He doesn't really approve. Well, he does, in theory. He's pretty liberal, but in practice, he's just afraid something might happen to me.
Sounds like a sensible man.
He is. Very sensible. That's the trouble.
Mimi's father's a doctor.
A doctor, is that right? Where does he practice?
In Buffalo, the existential armpit.
Well, well, well.
Where's Buffalo?
It's a city in upstate New York.
Is it a big city?
Yes, it is.
Medium size, I'd say, in all ways. That was delicious. It was the best meatloaf I've ever had.
Her mother's recipe. Woman was a fine cook. I believe I'll have one of those cigarettes, if you don't mind.
Since when did you start smoking again?
I'm not smoking again. Just taking a puff or two.
They're French.
French, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Traveled a lot, did you?
I spent a year in Sweden. It's when I still thought I wanted to study philosophy. Kierkegaard. My grief is my castle. You should know, by the way, that the Swedes are with us 100%.
Us?
You, me, the civil rights movement. The Swedish parliament passed a resolution officially condemning racism.
That's good to know. Mimi, as crazy as I may think you are, I just want to say it took a lot of courage for you to do what you're doing.
Mr. Coleman, it takes a lot more courage just to get through what you have to suffer every day of your life.
Our days aren't so bad.
Ain't a piece of cake either.
We do more than just suffer.
I didn't mean that. Of course you do. You laugh, you play with your kids, you fall in love just like everyone else. I know that. I'm just saying that you've been treated badly, and I want it to stop.
All right. Mr. Larkin, the Attorney General is going to be 15 minutes late.
We've been sitting here for an hour.
Rank has its privileges.
I wonder if I've covered the jurisdiction issue.
You're gonna wear those cards out.
All right, I'll tell them. I'm really sorry. That was the house. The Attorney General won't be in today after all.
Are you serious?
Would you like to reschedule for next week?
No, I wouldn't. I came up just for this meeting. I was led to believe it was important that I be here.
Can I use the phone?
Of course.
Thanks. Don't despair. Marcy, hi, Nick Larkin. Can I talk to Tim? Thanks. Tim, how goes it? Listen, I got one of the guys in town for the day. Forrest Bedford. Right. He's got a deal he'd like to discuss with you. Take maybe 20 minutes. Terrific. Thanks. Tim Underhill, Bobby's special assistant. You're in after lunch.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Son, if you fail this part of the test, you can take it two more times.
Eyes on the road.
Turn right. Pull up next to that car and stop. Parallel park. Edford. You any kin to Forrest Bedford?
Yeah, he's my father.
That right? Your daddy's a brother of that Reverend Bones, ain't he?
Son.
Pull on out. Drive straight ahead. Stop. Back up to that corner. Your daddy's upset quite a few white people in this town, hasn't he?
Sir?
Stop. Turn right.
It's a one way.
Back up.
I think the climate in this country is far different than it was 17 years ago. I believe we can impanel a jury that will convict and that a decision taken today will be upheld regardless of appeal.
How do you put the perps at the scene of the crime?
I went over the court transcript.
Marcy, put those over on the desk, please.
I looked at the court transcript and I found a number of discrepancies in the testimony.
Forrest feels this is winnable, Tim. I'm inclined to agree with him.
All right, let's go for broke. And you guys realize I'm sticking my neck out a little bit here. You see that it doesn't get chopped off for me, all right?
I'll do my best to see it stays intact. Due to the nature of the case, I need to know I have the complete cooperation of the Bureau. This might require undercover work, perhaps infiltration of the Klan.
Yeah, Marcy, get me Dave Siddons over at the Bureau. Let me see if I can grease the skids a tad. Dave, this is Tim Underhill. Our new man in the 5th District's gonna need a little help from your office. Forrest Bedford. F-O-R-D. He's here right now. I'm gonna put you on the box. Can you read us? Okay.
5 by 5. What's the scoop?
Hello, sir. This is a civil rights issue, Mr. Siddons. Two white men killed a colored Air Force officer.
Dave?
I'm here.
We were hoping you could make sure your man's on board down there.
Monty Pruitt. I'll give him a call today. Listen, I heard you broke 40 on the back nine.
Now, that's nothing but a nasty rumor.
Yeah, well, you're not getting another stroke off me either way.
Just don't play through the 19th hole, bud.
That's what my wife keeps telling me.
Sister Harper, good to see you. Please, sit down. What's on your mind?
I'd like to ride on the Freedom Bus. Maybe not this one. Another time. What would you say?
I'm not the one in charge, Sister Harper. But if you want my opinion, I'd probably say no.
Why?
Because you have family, a job. These are mostly college kids.
Reverend Henry, one time you told me, this is your movement, welcome to it. Did you mean that?
I did. And I still do.
Why does it always have to be about white people? Like they're doing this for us.
They're not doing anything for us. This is an integration movement. There are Negro students on that bus, too.
I know.
The police dropped Weber and Hughes off at the state border. We're getting back on another bus as soon as it can be arranged. We'll meet him at Brighton Falls. Listen, I gotta get in touch with everybody tonight. Where's the phone sheet?
Downstairs. Lucien.
Yes.
Sister Harper would like to ride on the Freedom Bus.
Sister Harper. Those students, colored and white, are this country's best and brightest. They're a photograph on the front page of the New York Times. You are not.
I don't want to be on the front page of the New York Times.
Good, because frankly, you wouldn't be much good to us there. Mr. Joe Blow opens up his daily newspaper and sees you step off that bus, so what? But if Mr. Joe Blow sees a colored college student getting off that bus, he sits up. He takes notice. And if he sees little Dexter or little Susie getting off that bus, he really takes notice.
What Mr. Van Ness is trying to say, Lily, is that we are now making history for the first time since the Civil War or Reconstruction. And we must do everything within our power to make sure that we never fall out again.
We are fighting a war for recognition, Sister Harper. Our enemy is invisibility.
Yes?
Hello.
Christina?
Am I interrupting anything?
No, no, I just wasn't expecting to hear your voice. Is anything wrong?
No. I just wanted to talk.
No, I'm sorry. We haven't spent any time together. It's my fault. Maybe I worry too much about what other people think. I'm very glad you called. I wish you were here right now.
You really mean that, Forrest? Well, that's a relief to hear. Because I'm here in Washington.
What?
Took a plane up. Should I take it back?
No, are you kidding? Where are you? Why didn't you just tell me you were here in the first place?
I got cold feet. What if you didn't want to see me?
You know, my mother used to say, Forrest, don't be so shy. If you wait for a woman to make the first move, all you'll ever meet are pushy women.
Is that what I am? Pushy?
You can be quite impelling.
I have an excuse.
I'm researching a case at the Library of Congress. Gray Kurt Chemical versus Proto Chem, disputing a drill bit copyright.
Now, there's a case to stir the blood.
You realize we've never done this before, Forrest? Just walk along a street at night, arms around each other, talking about work, not looking over our shoulders.
You are so beautiful.
I was nervous. Only because you're free to do what you want now. And I didn't know if you'd be alone.
Bite your tongue.
Welcome home.
I missed you.
I missed you, too.
Hi, Daddy.
Hey.
What'd you bring back?
Well, that's a direct approach. Let's waste no time on amenities. What's the matter? You said you wanted a gun.
I meant the gun.
Well, I'm sorry, John Morgan. I thought that would suffice. Here. Maybe you'll like this better.
Wow, a junior special agent.
This is an actual badge from the Justice Department gift shop.
Now all I need is a Tommy gun, and I'll be just like Elliot Ness.
You're already untouchable.
Francie, this is for you.
A blouse. Thanks, Dad.
You're welcome.
Hello, Mr. Bedford. Will you want to eat now?
No, I had breakfast on the train, Lily. Thanks for staying over last night. It's for you. Go on and open. I remembered you said you lost your new scarf, and I saw this one, and I thought you might like it.
I don't know what to say. Thank you.
You're welcome. Nathan? I didn't forget you.
I had Mr. Wofford give it a thorough going over. He says it's good for another 100,000 miles. I drove it back from the station, runs like a top.
Where's the grain?
Oh, wow. It's all yours.
Wow.
Thanks, Dad.
Is it big enough?
Really, I mean, it's,
I raised the whole thing before I left. When a young man gets his driver's license, he needs something to drive. Congratulations.
Well, I haven't got my license yet.
What?
I didn't pass.
I warned you what would happen if you didn't study.
Oh, here we go.
You can't succeed at something if you don't prepare for it.
I didn't flunk the written test. It was the behind the wheel, and the guy had it in for me.
Don't be ridiculous. Why would he have it in for you?
Because you're my father. He doesn't like you or what you stand for, so he's taking it out on me.
I'm sure he doesn't like me. But you can't go through life blaming outside forces for your failures, either. I also know about your jackrabbit starts and riding the brakes. When can you take the test again?
Not for 2 weeks.
Well, that'll give you plenty of time to get familiar with your own car. Come on. Let's take her for a quick spin.
I can't. We've got a test today. We've got to go study.
Monty, thanks for stopping by.
Yeah, sure thing. What can we do for you?
Have a seat.
Thank you.
I just wanted to touch base, see what your schedule was.
Well, never too busy for lunch.
No, I mean about the Landers case. I need to get started as soon as possible.
I'm not following you, Forrest.
Dave Siddons? He did call you, right? I was in D.C. yesterday. He said he'd get in touch with you right away.
Well, I'm sure if Dave said he'd call, he'd call. What's it about?
I might need some men to go undercover.
What for?
I want them to dig into the circumstances surrounding Colonel Lander's murder. I believe there's a civil rights angle.
No problem. You prosecute, we investigate. That's what the I stands for.
Monty? Word is your department had an informant tell you that there was going to be trouble at the bus terminal the other day. I gather you decided not to intervene?
Word? I never heard it.
We are on the same side, aren't we, Monty?
I always pride myself on my ability to work with anyone.
I'm not sure that answers my question.
I'm a team player. I put my own feelings aside every morning when I walk into this building.
Did you tell your dad you got a sickle?
I started to the other day, but then he jumped all over me. And he turns around and gets me this orphan.
What kind of car is this anyway?
I think it used to be a tank.
Yeah, on the other side. That's how come we won the war.
You know the story of Paul Bunyan and his blue ox, babe? Well, this heap is like something she dropped.
A gigantic cow pie. The world's largest meadow muffin.
That's it. The muffin. We're going cruising in the muffin. The genuine piece of dew.
Have some Duke Ellington in that pile.
This next part is amazing. He plays between the harmonies.
I like the boy. My nephew gave me that record. But after an hour or two, it makes you nostalgic for Funiculi Funicula.
Mama! Mimi's been teaching me all about jazz. She says it's the only real American music.
Lily, this child loves to learn. She's got a phenomenal memory. Who's playing drums on this song?
Art Taylor.
And who do you replace?
Lewis Hayes.
Yes. You see what I mean? You're leaving? Mr. Van Ness is picking me up. Thanks for letting me stay in your house. It's been really nice. You're such a good cook. You're welcome.
Mimi, will you help me with my homework?
Both Catholic? Come on. What are you learning?
Words. Chapter 3, Mimi. The page with the picture of the dog chasing the red ball.
This book is crap. What do you mean? It's crap. A, it's published by some antediluvian company in Ohio I've never even heard of. It's published before the Second World War, for God's sake. B, the conditions appalling. Look, entire pages are missing. Gone. Adeline doesn't stand a chance. They're crushing her.
Adeline, come to your room, please.
Why is Mimi crying?
We'll talk about it later. Go to your room. What the hell are you crying about?
What do you mean?
Don't you have any respect?
So much, you've no idea.
If you had any respect for me, you would never, ever have said what you just said in front of my child.
I don't understand.
You would if this wasn't just some field trip to you, some chapter in your history thesis.
Lily, I think it's your lack of enfranchisement talking, not your better sense.
Miss McGaffin, what you don't know is this movement didn't come down from above. It swelled up from below.
I'm sorry. Maybe I should wait for Mr. Van Ness out on the porch.
You don't have to make a big deal and wait on the porch.
What time is it?
It's late.
Well, I better close up the house.
No, I'll do it. I'll make sure everything's okay.
It is late. Where have you been?
Out. Dad.
Yes, son.
Thank you for the car.
You're welcome.
Listen, there's probably something I should tell you.
What is it, Nathan?
It's nothing. No big deal. It probably just needs a new thermostat.
Have Wofford look at it. Well, I'm blessed.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Coffee smells good. Sugar?
Right in front of you.
Oh, my God. Look at this.
Bus filled with alleged freedom riders was stopped by a crowd just outside the state border last night and set on fire. One of the riders, Horton Dickerson, English major at Halstead Junior College, was critically injured with a spinal fracture and is expected to be paralyzed from the waist down. I met him.
Seven other persons were also injured. Four of them, seriously.
Any names?
Just says the injured were taken to local hospitals.
Adelaine tells me she hates boys, yet I've seen her watching Sammy Irvin next door with a look like joy in her eyes. Daddy says politics are a waste of time, but come every election, he knows more about each candidate than anyone else. We're all made up of little secrets. We hide ourselves from the world. Nobody knows who we are.
On the next, I'll Fly Away.
Can I help you, boys?
We want to make a night of it.
I'm going to have to look for other employment.
I'd be sad on many levels to see that come to pass.
I can't marry you. There's too much of the world I ain't seen, too much I ain't done.
You mean too many women you ain't slept with?
You'd become an informant against a criminal organization. I'm talking about the Ku Klux Klan.
Next week, Forrest hires a young convict to infiltrate the Ku Klux Klan, and Paul refuses to marry Parkey, who has him arrested for rape. Be with us when I'll Fly Away returns, next Friday at 8. In a few moments, Nova will reveal the ancient secrets of how the Egyptian pyramids were built by actually building one. This old pyramid is next on Your Window to the World.